A very good afternoon to one and all. I, Ankita Joshi, with my co-presenter.
I, Mamta Reddy.
From River Narmada, are here to present a topic which is success story of heritage foods. The contents are introduction, vision and mission, products, locations, overview, acquisitions, revenue, success factors, competitors versus heritage foods, market size and market share, and conclusion.
So, introduction. The Heritage Foods Limited was founded on 10 July 1992 and the founder is the former Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Chandrababu Naidu. And the headquarters is in Hyderabad. Tagline of this company is Health and Happiness. The business units at present are dairy and renewable energy. Though it was started with three business units, which also includes retail, they were sold. And the subsidiary company is Heritage Nutrient Limited. And the vision and mission. The vision of this company is to provide fresh and healthy products to the consumers and empowering the farmers by providing the fair prices for their products. And the mission. To be nationally recognized brand with a revenue of 6,000 crore by 2020. And relationship farming model. This was included in the mission to empower the farmers by including the direct relationship between the farmers and the customers. To set up a greenfield yogurt plant. So under this, with the use of the technology, the yogurt will be preserved for the long period when compared to the traditionally preservation. And last one is improve the value added products from 22.43 at present to 40% by 2022.
So, product. There are 22 different products that Heritage Foods caters to the customers there. Few are dairy products. Dairy products contains the 63% of revenue is included in the dairy products. So dairy products contains milk and as milk. Milk and then milk products. Milk products contains cheese, butter, buttermilk, etc. So milk products contains 34% of the total revenue of Heritage Foods, and then even dairy products contains flavored milks, lassi, desserts, frozen desserts, etc. Talking about daily and even they give daily fresh needs, instant foods, staples such as wheat, rice, pulses, lentils, etc. And then renewable energy is also one thing that Heritage Food provides like it is in this products category. Renewable energy in all is 10.39 megawatt, and renewable energy consists of two things, that is solar power and wind power. Solar power consists of 4.09 megawatt, and wind power consists of 6.30 megawatt.
Locations. It was first started in Chittoor, Andhra Pradesh, because of the high procurement and yielding of the cow milk in that place. And now at present it was expanded in 15 states, which includes Telangana, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Delhi, etc. And it also exports dairy products to the foreign countries, which mainly include Europe, Gulf and several countries in Asia. The main products they export are pure ghee, butter and the skim milk powder.
Overview of Heritage Foods. Like 15 lakh families consume heritage products on a daily basis, and then 1400 heritage parlors are operated by the franchises throughout the nation, and 125,000 retail outlets sell heritage food products in their parlors, and 188 bulk coolers and mini chilling and chilling centers are being kept for the procurement of milk and milk daily. And then 3 lakh farmers are there who supply fresh milk twice a day.
So acquisitions. In May 2016, Heritage Food Limited has acquired Tejar Dairy, which is a Karnataka-based company, for the processing to improve the processing capacity, and they have acquired an asset which contains the dairy plant, which has 20,000 liters per day, the capacities. And in October 2016, it also acquired Reliance Retail Dairy to go to the northern states of India because it's easy for the Reliance. And they have acquired 2 brands of Reliance into their portfolio, that is dairy, fresh dairy and fresh pure. And on the same year, HFL sold its loss-making retail arm, agri and bakery businesses to Kishore Biyani Future Retail Limited, which has 3.65% stake and the revenue. The revenue is increasing from 2013 to 15-16, and the present 18-19 revenue is to 482 crore, and in 16-17 it was decreased to some extent because of the acquisitions and the company sold some businesses. Success factors. First is procurement of the fresh raw milk. The procurement consists of collection and transportation of the fresh milk, which includes 3 lakh farmers within the 9 states. And distribution reach and availability of products. It is really important to distribute the raw, the milk and the value-based products to the place on time. And they have very established distribution network with 1400 heritage parlors and 2000 outsourcing vehicles and around 6600 agents. And next, Heritage Farmers Welfare Trust. It was established on Feb 2010 to empower the education and all the skill development with the India Memorial Trust. And this includes these sources and first insurance coverage to the farmers. They have provided more than 2 lakh farmers the insurance policies, that is GPA policies. And veterinary health care services are provided to the cattle feeds, milk collection centers, the milk cans, the mosquito nets, everything are provided to the farmers. And the farmers' children were given the merit awards who are in SSC, and they also conduct blood donation camps.
Competitors versus heritage foods. Now we can see here the competitors of heritage foods. Nestle tops the list, and heritage foods revenue is 2,482 crores, and the net profit is 83.44. And as we can see, the turnovers of the few companies are much more than Heritage Foods. But yes, as Heritage Foods is. It is increasing its paths, and even they are including much more strategies to work upon their sales and market size and market share. The market size is 39,531 crores INR, and as we can see. Heritage Foods, that is in green color, the green color, the dark green color, we can see it is 6.27%, and the others containing Nestle, etc. conclusion, coming to the conclusion, they are trying to expand their areas, as I said, including North Indian states.